the distinct pleasure of welcoming you all at the annual umbrella gathering, Excellence Through Collaboration, jointly organized by the Russian National Association of Teachers of English, the English Language Office of the U.S. Embassy Moscow, and Moscow Region State Institute of Humanities and Social Studies. And the two-day brainstorming sessions we are going to participate in are to define the most important issues, projects, and trends in the English language teaching practice in Russia for the coming year. And we do hope that all of us will be able to fulfill the packed schedule of the conference and enjoy the stay in Kolomna. So, and now the floor for the opening statement is given to the Deputy Rector of Moscow Region State Institute of Humanities and Social Studies, Doctor of Economics, Professor Жанна Леонова.
Добрый день, уважаемые коллеги. Добрый день, уважаемые гости нашего древнего города. Мы очень рады приветствовать вас на нашей земле и очень рады приветствовать в стенах нашего института. Московский государственный областной социально-гуманитарный институт в этом году справляет 75 лет. То есть мы являемся одним из, скажем так, опытных, я бы сказала старых, а именно опытных вузов юго-восточного региона Московской области. Мы очень рады, что такое вот сообщество, занимающееся коммуникационными связями между Россией и англоговорящими странами, посетила наши стены. Наш институт является, скажем так, вузом, который направлен на социально-гуманитарный аспект. И иностранный язык, мы полностью уверены, и наше руководство поддерживает, является одним из тех направлений, которое позволяет расширять вот эту самую гуманитарную направленность нашего образования. Я хочу сказать, что факультет, который сегодня в своих стенах, вот на своем, как мы говорим, самом высоком этаже нашего здания принимает вас, в этом году тоже является юбиляром. Ему исполняется 55 лет, поэтому руководство факультета и, надо сказать, весь коллектив факультета формирует и хранит те традиции, которые наш факультет иностранных языков сформировал. У нас на данный момент сейчас готовится 27 направлений, то есть у нас 27 направлений по подготовке бакалавров существует, у нас 10 базовых факультетов. То есть вуз не так уж и, скажем так, может быть, мало, как покажется по сравнению с МГУ и другими лидерами. Но я хочу сказать, что мы играем очень большую роль в юго-восточном регионе. Мы готовим учителей, прежде всего, и в том числе учителей иностранных языков. И я так думаю, что очень многие из тех, кто работает в юго-восточном регионе Московской области в школах и в вузах, являются прежде всего нашими выпускниками. Поэтому сразу хочу сказать, что вот присутствие такого собрания на территории нашего вуза является для нас и почетным, с одной стороны, а с другой стороны, является собранием, которое, я думаю, готово поделиться с нами всеми умениями, навыками, своими эмоциями, которые вы приобрели вот в процессе общения на иностранных языках. Я с удовольствием и с радостью могу отметить, что несмотря на все, скажем так, проблемы, которые иногда возникают там, наверхах, между нашими политическими лидерами, я всегда рада, когда простые люди, профессионалы своего дела, с удовольствием общаются, приезжают к нам и готовы вот на своем уровне вот эти коммуникации сохранять и расширять. Поэтому я вам, уважаемые коллеги, желаю сегодня и завтра хорошо поработать, хорошо отдохнуть, хорошо подпитаться друг от друга положительными эмоциями. И я желаю, чтобы все самое положительное, которое готов отдать древний город наш, вы смогли увести с собой. Поверьте мне, я думаю, что экскурсия у вас будет, да, по нашей старой части города. Говорят, что место это намоленное. Говорят, что эмоции потрясающие. Мы-то привыкли, уже живем во всем в этом, да? А люди, которые приезжают со стороны, говорят, что история сама дышит в нашем городе. И вот я вам всем желаю вот этот вот положительный заряд, который есть в нашем институте, на факультете иностранных языков, на земле нашего города увести с собой. Я надеюсь, что все сложится так, как вы запланировали. И, как всегда, как говорится, ну, мы рады вас видеть здесь. Хочу еще отдельно большое спасибо сказать хозяевам сегодняшнего мероприятия. Это факультет иностранных языков, коллективу. Я надеюсь, что они сделают все, чтобы вам было здесь комфортно. Успехов вам!
And now the floor is given for the welcome speech to the Dean of the Foreign Languages Department, Professor Irina Salamatina.
Hello. Dear guests, I'm honored, proud, and happy to welcome all so many professionals from ELT circles to our umbrella gathering at our university. Teaching English is all about opening doors to participate in a larger world outside. For us English teachers, English is more than a language. It's an essential tool to use the same language the same language on critical issues to be solved. That is what you devote yourselves to, selflessly and wholeheartedly. I would like to express my appreciation to all the English teachers in this hall. Teachers like you open the doors to peace and collaboration throughout the world. And by working together at the Umbrella Conference, you will be able to open even more doors. Before leaving the stage, I would like to thank all those who put their hard and valuable efforts into the realization of this event. Our special thanks go to Елена Лукнина and Фомина, Светлана Рисова, Вера Гришенко and Степанова Наталья. I would like to thank all the participants from all over Russia for their attendance. And of course, it's also our great pleasure and privilege to have speakers from the American Embassy here today. Thank you very much for coming to us. And let me finish my speech with a well-known note. Heavy rain showers remind me of challenges in life. Never ask for a lighter rain. Instead, pray for a better umbrella. I wish our umbrella could protect us from the heavy storms. Thank you.
And now the opening welcome speech from the new English language office, Jerry G.
Hello everybody, Dobry den. Imenu zavut Jerry Frank. Я не замерил. Я не могу говорить по-русски, извините. Можно английский? Спасибо. So as Anna told you, I'm the new English language officer in Moscow. This is my second tour as an English language officer. And before that, I was an English teacher just like you. I spent more than 25 years teaching English. I was a teacher trainer. Most of my time was in Japan, but also spent some time in Korea, and I taught and did some teacher training in the United States as well. Before this, I was working as a regional English language officer in Ukraine, where I covered 6 countries. So now it's kind of exciting to be in the biggest country in the world and have only one country. I'd like to thank our hosts in Kelowna, Dean, Vice Rector, Vera, Svetlana, Natasha. You're Natasha. Vera, Natasha. So, this is the 15th Umbrella Conference. 15. So you would know because you've been at all 15. Who else has been at all 15? Who's been to all 15? Anybody? No? No?
I went to 13.
You went to 13? Well, I'd like to thank all of you for coming. Who came the furthest?
Vladivostok.
Vladivostok?
Vladivostok.
You came all the way from Vladivostok. Wow. So, how do you say jet lag in Russian?
Jet lag.
Do you have jet lag? So, why is it called the Umbrella Conference? Elena told me, but I want to know what you know. You told me that an umbrella is, it's like a parachute, right?
It's something to compare with mindset.
Right. So if it's not open, it doesn't work. Очень глубокий. And the title of this year's conference is Excellence Through Collaboration. Who thought of that title? Was that you? Well, before I came to Russia, I've already heard how famous Russian English teachers were for their competency and how great the professional teachers organizations were here. I think a strong and well-organized professional teachers organization like NAIT and all the affiliates are very important for the health of our profession. Not only do you provide a platform for professional development for your colleagues or for younger teachers, for yourself, but also I hope that you'll be the advocates for your field. That you'll be the first people that when someone is making a decision about the future of English language learning and teaching, you guys should be the first ones they talk to. And you guys should be in a position to shape and move policy. It's because of you, all the new styles and methods of teaching here in Russia aren't new. They become common practice because of your hard work and your dedication. And I know there are many, many homegrown experts here. We don't need to go overseas. We don't need to invite specialists from America or other places to come all the time because we have a lot of experts here in this room. And I'm really looking forward to learning from you and working with you over the next couple of days. And like the title says, excellence through collaboration. We need to work together to identify where we need to make English teaching and learning stronger in Russia. And the partnership that our office has with you is so important because without your input, your feedback, we wouldn't know how to proceed. And we do have some resources that we can help you do your jobs more effectively and maybe help improve the field a little bit. But my main job, I think, is to promote mutual understanding through language teaching and learning. And I think that's a phrase I learned in Russian. Let me try. Я хочу помочь дизайну понимаю через английский язык. So I'd like again to thank the organizers here, and Elena, I think we should all give them another big round of applause. Natalia got up at 5 o'clock this morning on all over Moscow, did a round trip, so thank you very much.
The usual stuff.
I heard Russian teachers are really tough. Not only that, you're smart, you're tough, you're good-looking. I'm really happy to be here. So for the next 2 or 3 days, I'm looking forward to hearing from you and working with you. And thank you so much for coming.
Dear friends, you know, at this moment, I think I can say it. Usually I start all my letters with dear colleagues. But now when I see you here, I can say dear friends. I have only 5 minutes, and I think that I have already told you what is ahead, what we are going to do during this day and a half of very, very, sometimes exhausting, but exciting brainstorming sessions. I would like to ask you to work in different groups during lunches, during dinners, during excursions, and come up with tangible results. As Jerry said, we depend on you. You depend on yourselves. At this time, the times of challenges, by the way, I was really happy to hear from our guests that they used this word, the time of changes and challenges that is reflected not only in the name of our conference, but local conference as well. There are different ways how we can behave. You know, we discussed this topic many times with Svetlana Grigorievna Terminas. It's so easy to say, I cannot stand it anymore. It's so easy to say, I do not want to do anything with it. But I would like to remind you a fable. What is happening to 3 things, a carrot, an egg, and coffee, if you put it in hot boiling water? Carrot gets softer, egg gets harder, coffee is dissolved and changes water into a beautiful drink. So that is the change. And it is challenging change. And you are the agents of change. So I thank you for finding time and energy and bringing here your ideas, bringing here your heart, fantastic level of knowledge, and for being so fantastic teachers ready to work together. Enjoy, and as you know, I always repeat the same thing. I envy myself because I am privileged to know you and work with you. Thank you, best wishes.